request our honorable chief minister to give his inaugural address. Sir.
Chairman Troy, R.S. Sharma ji, Honorable Deputy Chief Minister, Sri Chinaraja Pagaru, Honorable Minister for IT and PR, Sri Lokesh Garu, Honorable Minister for Education, Sri Ganta Srinivasrao Garu, Advisor IT, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Sri J.A. Chaudhary Garu, Principal Secretary IT, Sri Vijayanand Garu, CEO E. Pragati, Sri Balasubramanian Garu, and also respected business leaders, entrepreneurs, decision makers in governments, and thought leaders among others. I am very happy. Always I am addressing so many meetings. This is a unique meeting. Why I am saying? This is a new technology. We are creating an ecosystem. Earlier, I remember very well, I wanted to go differently. That is in 1995. Our combined state of Andhra Pradesh at that time was agrarian state. So I thought, which is the best way to move from now onwards? I had a different type of brainstorming sessions. Ultimately, we created iTech City. Then we created Cyberabad City. If you see today, within 20 years' time, one of the best ecosystem we were able to create in Hyderabad. Same thing today, 2 years back we started FinTech in Visakhapatnam. I am very happy so many within the state, some of them are national, some of them global entrepreneurs are here. I am confident Visakhapatnam will become one among top 3 or 4 in the world on FinTech. I don't have any doubt about it. Beautiful city. Nowhere you will find this type of ecosystem, first of all. Excellent beaches. Next to that, excellent hills. And also if you see, very good summer resorts. And also, this eco, people are very docile, very positive thinking. All these factors, it will help us to create one of the best ecosystem in FinTech itself. I am very happy. I learned so many things today also I am discussing. On information technology, now we are going differently in knowledge economy. In knowledge economy, innovation and incubation and startup, it is order of the day. And I strongly believe we are in an inspiring time because of technologies, not only technologies, and also anything you wanted to get it done, it will be done in real time. For this purpose, our government, after bifurcation, there are so many challenges. But always we want to convert challenges into opportunity. That is where we are working today. By using information technology, not only information technology, all latest technologies, you name IoT, you name artificial intelligence, you name cloud management, everything we are using in governance. Ultimately, our aim is visible governance, invisible government. We are one way ahead of others. India, we are having one more advantage. This is Aadhaar. All benefits as on today, if you see, because of Aadhaar authentication, we can go foolproof system. That is the best advantage we are having as on today. That's why I wanted to make Andhra Pradesh totally as an innovation valley. Now people are talking Silicon Valley. Any innovation means it will come from Silicon Valley. I am confident with all your support and also your participation. Any innovation in future means that is from Innovation Valley, that is from Andhra Pradesh, that type of ecosystem we want to create in the near future. You are all aware, Visakhapatnam, FinTech city we are creating, so many players have come. And also Amaravathi, we want to go for knowledge economy. In knowledge economy, this is a new city, greenfield city. Earlier, we created Hyderabad as a brownfield city. Now, in Amaravathi, there are 9 cities: Media City, Government City, Justice City, Finance City, Knowledge City, Tourism City, and also Electronic City and Sports City. And ultimately, this will be one of the best cities. We are benchmarking Amaravathi, one among top 5 in the world. It is possible. We are going to prove it because of technology, everything. This city will be totally knowledge economy. That is how we are going. Even you know Tirupati, that is one of the best employment zone. Tirupati and also Chennai and also Krishnapatnam, that is Nellore, that is tri-junction. It will be Silicon corridor itself. All hardware, electronics, we are going in a big way. Now around 30% of cell phones are being manufactured in that zone. Our aim is to go up to 60% or 70%. This will be the biggest cluster in India on hardware and electronics. Ultimately, our aim is happiness. The happiest and the most livable state by 2029, we want to make Andhra Pradesh. This is our vision. For that, this information technology is going to help us in a big way. As on today, we are having RTGS, real-time governance. No other state is having real-time governance. This is the biggest center in Asia itself. All 13 districts, 13 centers we are having. Total government is computerized. We are moving in the direction on e-platform. Because of Aadhaar, all government programs, we can have authentication. Apart from that, every transaction and also government to government, government to citizen, citizen to citizen, everything online. In future, I am very happy by seeing all these things. Real-time citizens we can engage. Either welfare or regulatory or development, I can monitor real time. Today, this month, my citizen satisfaction is 76% on government. Different programs differently. Some of the program 95%. Some of the programs 90%. What it indicates, automatically I can drill down to the last functionary, last mile functionary, and also last mile unit, administrative unit, and also I can monitor, is there any technology failure or behavioral problems or some other problems. Everything we can monitor. On the basis of that, I can give skill building and capacity building, and also I can change the functionaries. I am very happy today you have seen here how it is going to happen. 2 days, our people have given very good advertisement on Sophia. Everybody is expected Sophia will come now. Today, man behind it has failed. Sophia is ready. But who handled it, technology has failed. This is where I am saying, technology, artificial intelligence will come, everything will come. Ultimately, man behind is very important. Otherwise, all these robots, artificial intelligence, everything will be on paper. It will be on only theory. This is where I am saying, if you provide proper leadership, you can get it done, anything in this matter. Today, all my government transactions, 200 people are working to contact people regularly. 1.5 million telephones every day we are sending so that I can obtain feedback. I can go machine learning, artificial intelligence, and also everything on programming, what is happening, all these things. Because of all these things, if you see here, we are able to grow 10.5% growth rate for the last 4 years average. I am not happy with that. My target is 15%. People are saying, is it possible? I said, it is possible. We can get it done. That is how we are planning. Another 15 to 20 years, CAGR 12% I want to grow. It is possible. We wanted to prove it. Sometimes we are having some problems also. Nature will play adversely. In South India, you are all aware, we are having water problem. But human beings are doing extremely well, but there is a problem of drought, something. Even that problem, if you can address properly, you can overcome that problem also. That is where we are working in that direction. We are having rivers. We are linking of rivers in a big way. And also rainwater, we are converting into groundwater. By doing all these things, even water management, we are going in a big way for micro irrigation. By doing this type of activities, the day will come very soon. We will face even drought very effectively. In government, if you see here, so many policies we are able to bring. Even by discussing with you all of you, as on today, if you see here, ITES and electronics, including consolidated IT policy, electronics policy, DPT, DTP policy, GIC policy, IIT policy, cyber security policy, innovation and startup policy, cloud hub policy, even animation, visual effects, and gaming policy, all these things we are bringing. Why I am saying, ultimately, transparency is very, very important. If I do something, if I do according to policy, then everybody will appreciate. Then automatically, everybody will follow. If I do only discriminatory, then people will create problems in democracy. That's why we are bringing all policies, even big investors, we are taking to the cabinet. We are giving one of the best incentive systems also. By using information technology, as on today, we are number one in ease of doing business. 2 years continuously, we are number one. Government of India started 3 years how to award ease of doing business. First year, second, third year, second year, third year, we are number one. Now I am planning distant number one in India, one among top five in the world. We are engaging League One Institute also. Why I am saying, if you do business very comfortably, without paying any money, then you can imagine how things will happen. Even on corruption, recently, Transparency, some organization has done online survey. We are among all states, we are third in less corruption, lowest corruption in the country. But I am not happy. I wanted to be number one, distant number one, corrupt-free governance that is going to achieve. We are going to measure all these things through technology. Because of ease of doing business, we are able to attract one of the best companies. Investment is coming. And in the process, because of all these things, so much of employment we are able to generate as on today. And we are building institutions in a big way. This is also important. Andhra Pradesh Innovation Society, we are keeping 100 crores. Today I am very happy we are able to $1 million challenge fund also we are able to create. I wanted to advise our people every year we will create this challenge and also we will attract more and more innovative companies to participate in the challenge. Even if you see here, Andhra Pradesh Innovation Society, they are working with NASCOM and also they are working Govind Capital of Singapore and also we are going to, in a big way, CAI, we are going to work with them. And also Reliance is coming here to establish this type of innovation ecosystem. I am very happy 3-4 persons, mentors have come. They spoke very well. In this country, generally in the world also, there is a mismatch between institution and also industry. Of course, there is an exception some of the countries. In America, all leading institutions are different. Ultimately, our students are very bright. But you have to give some skill for them. Then they will behave differently. If you see in Andhra Pradesh, 20 years back, our students are not that much interested or participated in information technology. 1995, we started information technology in a big way. I made it quantum jump of colleges from 25 to 250 colleges within 9 years' time. Today, I will be very happy. Every 4 IT professionals in the world, one is Indian. Among Indians, out of 4, one is from Andhra Pradesh. That is our strength. Today, what is the ecosystem we are creating now? Tomorrow in knowledge economy, out of 4 knowledge economy, one will be in Andhra Pradesh. That is how we are going to create wealth. I am very happy. So many companies are here. So many individuals are here. All your innovations, where you are starting here, or you are having, already you are having some product on innovation, good product, it is useful for government or for public, we are prepared to immediately adopt it. That is where Chaudhary has rightly mentioned, we are having a session also. Very closely, government and private has to work together for overall benefit of the citizens. And also, if you can do that, then lot of advantage for common man we are going to create. This institutional framework, so many institutions you have to bring. Even we are having Andhra Pradesh Information Technology Academy and also Andhra Pradesh State Skill Development Corporation, International Institute of Digital Technologies, IIDT. This type of institutions we are able to establish as on today on blockchain, analytics, cloud, you name any latest technologies, we are using all these things. But at the same time, to create further best ecosystem, if we can bring either organizations or universities, we will be very happy to associate with you. This ecosystem is very, very important, not only fintech, for innovation. Innovation is a continuous process. And also, wherever there is innovation, it has to take the public utilization, then only we'll have excellent advantage. Our aim is in Andhra Pradesh, ease of doing business, we are number one today. We wanted to be distant number one among top 5 in the world. And also, we are going in a big way, ease of living. All services will be online. no need to go to anywhere. One cell phone is enough. One through app, any services of government with biometric authentication, and also all services will line. Even development, we want to engage citizens to participate. Citizen engagement is a continuous process. Then you can see the difference. Then naturally they will participate and we can do wonders. And also I told you, corrupt free governance. In governance, there won't be any corruption because there is no touch point at all. If you go to officer, if you go to somebody, if you depend on anybody, then you have to do some favor or you have to seek some favor. There is no touch point at all. Then automatically corruption will be minimized. It will be zero. We can make it. That is where we are working, corrupt free governance. Ultimately, I want to go most livable standards. I want to test real time water quality, air quality, and also even food quality. We are going zero budget natural farming, no fertilizer, no pesticide. You can imagine pollution. Today, we are all blessed again. Solar energy is coming. If you use solar energy for electrical vehicles, solar energy for power generation, you can imagine the difference. As on today, all thermal, nuclear, and also gas. Gas is less pollution compared to thermal. That is the order of the day. In future, if you use solar and go for in a big way, and also if you plant in a big way for CO2 neutral, greenery, everything, if you breathe good quality of air, if you eat, we are all eating today only fertilizers and pesticides. That is the reality today. But tomorrow, with technology, you can have a traceability. Which apple you are eating? Which field it is coming? What is the ingredients? What is the inputs we have applied? All these things you can see very easily. As on today, if you see here, real time, we are able to monitor rainfall, groundwater, surface water, street lights, even real time, we are monitoring cyclones, thunderbolts. Real time, we are able to communicate. Because of all these things, recently we had a severe cyclone, but human loss is only 8 people. You can imagine how it is happening. Exact location, we are able to trace now. Basing on that, we are able to take the precautions, preventive measures, and also we are able to save properties, and also we are able to protect lives also. Ultimately, this is where quality life with happiness. Use technology, get it done everything, provide quality life, and happiness, we have to engage continuously citizens in a big way. So this is the order of the day, what I am thinking. Everything is possible now. Human life should be a meaningful life with happiness as an index. Poverty should be eradicated. Today, we can plan macro level. We can execute micro level as a family, as a unit. That is the favor of technology. We can go artificial intelligence. You can go machine learning. You can know continuously what are all the factors. Sometimes people are not participating, ignorance. Sometimes people are not coming forward because of problems, because of knowledge, because of resources, because of a financial problem. Then on the basis of that, you can correct everything. That is the beauty of tomorrow. So with all these things, I am very happy. I have seen so many people here for fintech, for innovation. You have to create a big ecosystem, institutional framework, how to support, and how to strengthen existing universities, colleges, and at the same time, mentoring, how you are going to do it. I am very happy. Chaudhary just now announced 25 people were there. All of a sudden, so many people are showing interest. Now hundreds of people are going to come. It makes all the difference. Somebody wants to do something, or he needs some guidance. Right time, right guidance will take him anywhere in his imagination. And also venture capital. This is timely financing is very, very important. I am having ideas. I am having desires. But at the same time, I don't have money. Sometimes he may fail. Let him fail. But at the same time, you have to protect that type of vulnerabilities. That is where you have to work it out, venture capital. And ultimately, all your innovations, government is prepared to adopt immediately. Wherever there is a good innovation, we are prepared to adopt it and scale it up. And ultimately, you will have that platform. And at the same time here, we are having excellent data. No other state, no other country is going to provide that type of data. For innovators, you need some data also. That type of data is available. By using the data, you can work it out innovations further. Future, data is big wealth. If somebody is having excellent data, from there you can use it for so many innovations. We are having health data, agriculture, animal husbandry, so many departments. That data, you can use it for better innovations, and at the same time you can go for incubation and startup. And Andhra Pradesh, you can practice it, you can add value for that. Ultimately, tested product you can replicate in other states, other countries also. So I am very happy. Compared to earlier, now we are having clarity. Things are moving positively. Now Chaudhary is doing good work. I really appreciate him, advisor and also minister and also Vijayanand and the entire his team. They are doing very good work. But speed, yes, reasonably well, but they have to move internet of speed. Always in technology, speed is very, very important. So they have to make it one of the best ecosystem now. Then they have to put it on autopilot. Then results will come. That is what I am expecting. This area should be totally innovation valley. For that, we are prepared to extend all the cooperation. You are all our guests. I am confident our people will look after well for all of you. That is what I told them. Even all mentors, you can have a holiday once in 3 months, once in a month, 3 days. 3 days you can come to Visakhapatnam. Be our guest. Go to students. Spend half a day, 1 day with them. And also you go to beach. Spend half a day. Go back to your work. You will do better work compared to what you are doing. Take holiday, produce results here, and at the same time go back and produce results there also. Treat Visakhapatnam as a holiday. Break your routine work. Then you can see the difference. We can do continuously students for a particular college, 5-10. You can have a chit chat and video conference. Even we are having a polycon. This is a teleconference, video conference. That students, they are having smartphone, you can have video conference. Even hundreds of people now. Thousands of people or lakhs of people. Not only sitting in video. Wherever you are going in car also, you can interact with your, you can play your mentoring role. Now communication is not a problem. And also knowledge is not a problem. Only problem is willing to do it, willing to share it. If you do that, we can do wonders. That is the biggest contribution for charity. What I am asking you are having knowledge. You share that knowledge for others for creating better things. Then it will have a multiplier effect, and ultimately not only giving money for charity, not only giving food for charity, Even giving knowledge for charity is important. You have to do that type of social work. That will be the biggest contribution from you, I am expecting. With this, I am having so much of confidence today. Every day I am talking to so many meetings. And what I am saying, knowledge economy, especially innovation, incubation and startup, I got a very good confidence. And also fintech is a reality. It will be among two, three in the world. Either New York or you can Singapore or London or Hong Kong, we can benchmark Visakhapatnam to that category. They are all here. Now we are having a consortium, e-coordination, and ultimately by sitting there you can work here. That is the order of the day. I am very happy and I wish all the best, and also for our remaining stay also, good luck, best of luck. Thank you and all.
All right, thank you very much to the Honorable Chief Minister for his wise words. With this, I would like to thank the dignitaries on the stage for their presence. Thank you very much to the Honorable Chief Minister, to the Honorable Minister for IT. Thank you very much, and all the dignitaries. Thank you for joining us, sir. And I would request the remaining guests to kindly be seated for a while we have the safe movement of the Chief Minister, post which we will be also breaking for a short tea break. We would request you to kindly stay seated due to security reasons. tea break now, but in the interest of time, unfortunately, as we are running late, this tea break would be for 10 minutes, and post that we will resume the session. So at 12:50, 12:45, 12:50, we will resume the session. So we do apologize for this discomfort caused to you, but post this, we'd be on schedule, so we'd request you to be back in 10 minutes maximum so that you do not miss the next session, which is going to be a panel discussion, an extremely powerful session on going digital. And you do not want to miss that session. We'd be starting at 12:50 with that session. Thank you very much. Please be back from the tea break. Thank you.